It was a splendid morning on the island of Sodor. James was feeling very pleased with himself. His red paint gleamed in the sunshine as he sped along the line. He reached the junction just as Percy arrived with some freight cars. James was surprised to see him.
"What are you doing here, Percy? You should be at the station by now."
"I know," sighed Percy, "but these cars have been troublesome all morning."
"That's no excuse, Percy. Nothing should stop us. Now if you'll excuse me, I'll be on my way."
And James puffed importantly away.
"Bossy buffers," muttered Percy.
James arrived at the harbor. It was market day. The harbor yard was filled with the sweet smell of fruits from faraway lands. The fruit was delivered in big ships. James watched as strawberries, oranges, melons, and bananas were carefully loaded into his cars. Then he set off for the stations on the main line. On the way, he met Thomas.
"Really reliable! That's me!" panted James. "Pity the same can't be said for Percy! Goodbye!"
"What was all that about?" asked Annie and Clarabel.
"That was trouble," said Thomas. "Trouble for James. Just you wait and see."
Percy was back at the yard, busy shunting. He had the cars in good order and was making up for lost time. But the station master had bad news.
"What's happened?" asked Percy's driver. "James's brakes are jammed. We need Percy's help right away."
Percy set off to the rescue. James was stuck on the line looking glum. Percy couldn't help laughing.
"Got yourself in a bit of a jam, eh, James? What you might call a sticky situation?" "Be quiet! It's not funny having jammed brakes."
"And not very reliable either. I'm surprised you let it happen, James. Nothing should stop us engines."
"That's enough, Percy," said his driver. "Can you push these cars?"
"Of course I can. There's no time to lose. James has done too much of that already."
James angrily hissed steam as Percy was coupled to his cars.
"Off we go," said Percy. "I'll have to go fast to get there in time. Those big engines are so unreliable."
"Be careful, Percy," called his driver. But Percy was in a hurry.
He didn't see that the points had failed and he had been diverted into a siren.
"Look out, Percy!" shouted his driver and applied the brakes, but it was too late.
The driver and fireman jumped clear, but squashed fruit squirted all over Percy. Sir Topham had arrived.
"Percy, you're not to blame for the points failure, but I do not run a jam factory."
"Yes, sir. No, sir."
And Percy squelched sadly away. That night, the shed was silent. Percy and James were feeling very sorry for themselves. At last, Edward spoke.
"You know," he said to no engine in particular, "there's more than one way to get jammed. We all learned that today."
Still, there was silence.
"What's more, we all learned when other engines help each other out of a, jam, things can still go wrong."
"So?" huffed a voice.
"So, that means we've learned a lot today. And therefore," then came a chorus, "we're really useful engines after all."